Fine, good afternoon to you all students. Hi students, how are you? I hope you all are fine and you all are doing well. I hope by God's grace you all are safe. So not only you, your parents and your family members all are safe, I think so. So pray to God for your health daily, okay? So students, so are you watching daily online classes? So please watch daily online class, okay? Don't waste time. This is the correct time for you to study, okay? Don't think it at last moment we can study. So please don't play this time, study, because daily I am taking some portions, isn't it? So please study daily portions, don't waste time, okay? So welcome to our today's online class, students. So now we are studying about chapter 1, function, isn't it? So what's the title for your chapter? So what's the title for your chapter? Function. So last week, so I have taught about some topics in this chapter, isn't it, Anna? Okay, so before I am going to start about the today's portion, so just recall, or just I am giving the outline, what are the things I have taught at the last week class, okay? So in this chapter, what are the things you have studied? What are the things you have studied? Very, very important 2 more questions you have studied. What are they? So define subroutine, then define function, then so write the inference of variable x colon equal to 78, then define parameters and arguments, explain the types. So till now you have studied about 3 important 2 mark question and 1 5 mark question. Isn't it? So what's the important 5 mark question? Define parameter and arguments and write the types. Okay. So from this surely you can expect 1 question for your annual exam. So don't waste time. Okay. So today you are going to study about syntax to define function. Okay. So till now you have studied about functions, isn't it? So now you are going to study about syntax to define function. Okay. So what do you mean by syntax? Last year you have studied, no? Syntax is nothing but just like a formula. Okay. So always you need to follow these rules while you are writing the function. Very, very important book inside 3 mark question, this one. Okay, this is not a book bag question. Book inside important 3 mark question. Please note it down. Okay, now first you listen. So if you are going to define a function, first listen, function always starts with the keyword let. That's the first point. Okay, what's the first point? See, what's the first point? Function always starts with the keyword let. Okay, then after the keyword let, the keyword let is followed by the name of the function. Understood? Second point. What's the first point? The function is always starts with the keyword let. Okay. Then after the keyword let, what you need to write? It is followed by the name of the function. So whatever name you are giving, you should write the name of the function after the keyword let. Okay. Then after the function name, after the name of the function or function name, you need to write arguments or parameters. Understood? So even the first point itself, 3 points are there. What are the 3 points? Say, function starts with the keyword. First point is function starts with keyword let. Okay. Then second point, the keyword let is followed by the name of the function. And the name of the function is followed by what? Arguments or parameters. Understood? Then after the arguments or parameters, you need to write, if you need to write any formula or any calculations or anything, so whatever may be, you should write all the calculations after an equal to sign. Understood? So argument you have written, then whatever formula or calculations you need to write after the equal to sign. That's the second point. Understood? Argument, after the arguments were written, then after the argument, what do you need to write? If you need to compute some formulas or calculations, you should write after the equal to sign. Understood? Then last point, Salad is a function and always starts with the keyword let. Sometimes if you need to define the function as a recursive function. Understood? If you need to define the function is a recursive function. Last year also you have studied about recursive function, isn't it? So if you need to define the function as a recursive function, mean you should define a keyword called REC along the keyword let. Understood? So if you need to define a function as a recursive function, means what you need to do? You should declare a keyword called what? REC. So after the keyword let, you need to include a word called what? REC. Instead of let, you need to define a keyword called REC. Understood? Sometimes they will give let REC some function name. So at that time, how you will identify the function? What's the name of the function? Recursive function. Understood? So once more, you see, very, very important book inside 3-mark question. So what are the points? First point is function always starts with the keyword let. Then followed by which name? Function name. Then after the function name, what you need to write? Arguments. Then after the arguments, if you need to compute any formula or calculations, you should write all the calculations after an equal to sign. At the same time, if you need to define function as a recursive function, mean you should define a which word? REC after the keyword let. Understood these points? Understood or not? Very, very important book inside 3-mark question. Okay, so now you are going to write the syntax. See this line. So what's the syntax? Function always starts with the keyword what? Let. See, so here I am giving the keyword as giving REC. So what's the function? So function, the keyword let is followed by the word REC, means which kind of function it is? Recursive function. Okay, then function let, keyword let is followed by which one? Name of the function or function name. So what's the function name they have given? What's the function name? Fn. Then after the function name, here they have given a1, a2 till an. What is that one? What is that one? Parameters. So what variable? Parameters are nothing but variables. Already you have studied. What do you mean parameters? Variables used in the function definition. So this and the variables. So already said, after these parameters, if you need to do any calculations or computations or constants or argument, all the things you need to write or all the things you need to write after the equal to sign. So which is the argument here? K. Understood? So listen carefully. So sometimes they will give the function like this. Like this line they will give let REC function something. So here they asked you to identify each and every tabs. How you need to write? Let is a keyword, then REC means recursive function. Listen, same question if I am not giving the keyword REC. Okay, same question if I am not giving the keyword REC, what you need to write? Means this is a normal function. Okay, if the keyword REC is not given in the along with the keyword let, means what's the answer? What's the answer? Normal function. So if a keyword REC is there, means which function? Recursive function. Understood? Okay. Then after this keyword and REC, so what's the next thing? Variables. What's the variables? What are the variables here? Sorry, what is Fn? Function name. Fn is function name. Whatever name you as per your wish, you can give any name. Then variables, then arguments. Understood? Very, very important. Book inside 3-mark question. So next one is recursive function. Okay, this also book inside 3-mark question. So while I am taking class itself, I am saying book back 2-mark question. So in this chapter, subroutines, functions, that function specification, x colon equal to summary. These 3 questions book back 2-mark question. So now I said no, this index to define function, that is book inside 3-mark question, recursive function. This also book inside 3-mark question. So why I am telling like this mean? So each day I will take only 2 or 3 questions only. Book inside and book back. So based on that, if you are studying means, surely I am telling you can able to score center mark in computer science subject. So please don't skip. Please study daily portion. This is the book inside question. Recursive function. So recursive function last year also you have studied. So 11th standard you have studied now. So what's the definition of recursive function? See? Function which call itself is called what? Recursive function. Isn't it or not? So what do you mean by recursive function? Function which Call itself is called which function? Recursive. That's a definition. If they ask for 3-mark question, means you should write definition. Okay. So if they ask for 2-mark question, means only definition alone enough. What's the definition? Function which call itself is called recursive function. That's enough. Okay. If they ask for 3-mark question, means you should write the definition as well as with example program. Understood? Okay. So last year you have studied one example program. Are you remembering? Program to find the factorial of a given number, isn't it? Yes. So here, this year they have given the example program for recursive function is program to check whether the given number is odd or even. Okay. So what program they have given for recursive function, or what's the best example? Program to check whether given number is odd or even. Sometimes if they ask this question for 2-mark question, means listen, you need to write this definition. A function definition which call itself is called recursive function. Then example you write this one. To example program to check whether given number is odd or even. That's enough. Okay. For 2-mark question. At the same time for 3-mark question, means you should explain this example. Full program. Understood? Now listen. Listen. Requires x greater than or equals to 0. What is this one? So if you studied that last class question, parameters and arguments, means you need to, you should know what's this line. What is this line? This line, the keyword requires, what's the keyword requires? Precondition or postcondition? Precondition. Requires always means that is condition giving at the first. What is called which condition? Precondition. So you are giving one condition. So what condition? Requires. So you are declaring one variable. What's the variable name here? X. Okay. And also what condition you are giving? X is always greater than or equal to 0. For example, you are going to check your given number is odd or even. Okay. So whether it is possible to check the negative numbers, that is below 0, minus 1, minus 2. No, you are not going to check like that. So always the number is greater than or equal to 0. Understood the first line? The given number. The number is given by the variable x. That number is always greater than or equal to 0. Understood all of you? So your condition requires. So it is a requirement. What's the require? The keyword is precondition. What's the condition you are giving? The variable x. The given number is giving in the variable x. Always the number is greater than or equal to 0. Understood? Okay. Then what is this line? Now only you have studied. What's the name of this line? Syntax to define function or function definition. How you should identify this is a function definition? Function always starts with a keyword let, isn't it? Okay, the function always starts with a keyword let, followed by which one? Let is followed by function name. But if the function is a recursive function, mean you should give which keyword? REC. So listen carefully, let is a keyword, then I am giving REC. What is the function name? The keyword REC followed by which one? Function name. So what's the function name here? What's the function name? Even. Then function name is followed by which one? Parameters or variable. So what variable already you have given? X. So I am giving the variable as that X. Understood? So any doubt in this line? So you are going to define a function. Function starts with the keyword let. Then it. So what's the name of this function? Even. So this line we can call which kind of function? Normal function or recursive function? Recursive function. Why? So here you are giving the keyword as REC. Understood? So in that syntax you have studied, all the calculations or what are the argument you need to write, means after the equal to sign only you need to write or do all the calculations. Okay, so I am ending here at equal to sign. So listen, after the equal to sign, next line I am writing. So now only I am going to check given number is odd or even. Listen, first condition I am giving x equal to 0. First condition x equal to 0 or one condition x equal to 0. This is called or operator. Or either the value of x is 0, otherwise odd of x minus 1. For example, take any one odd value. For example, I am taking the odd value as 3. Okay, what's my odd value? 3. So what's the value of x now? Odd value is 3. So 3 minus 1. Odd of. So you should take odd value. Why? Here I am giving the condition is odd, odd of x minus 1. So for example, I am taking odd values 3 or 5 or 7 or anything. So 3 minus 1, what value will get? 3 minus 1, the value is 2. So the value 2 is even or odd? You say the answer. 2 means even or odd? Even. So answer. So if it is even, means what answer you need to return? Return even. So return is a which condition? Pre-condition or post-condition? Post-condition, because it, the condition is requested the return at the last. Understood up to this? So first I am defining a function. So in this function, I am going to check whether the given number is even. So what's the condition? The given variable, the value of x is either 0 or any one odd of odd value minus 1. So any odd value minus 1 means you will get, anyway you will get the answer as even. So what answer you need to return? Return even. Understood? Next, same way I am going to write which one? Which function? So now I have checked for even number. Next you need to check for which one? Odd number. Listen. So here also I am giving the condition. Always the variable x greater than 0. Same only. So request x greater than 0. Listen. Let. So what's the name of this line? What's the name of this line? Function definition. So function always starts with which one? Keyword. Function always starts with the keyword. Let. Followed by which one? Function name. So here listen. Whether here the keyword or is there. No, keyword or is not there. So we can say this one is which kind of function? Normal function or recursive function? Normal function. Isn't it? Why? Because keyword or is not there. So let is followed by which one? Function name. So what's the function name? Odd. Next, I am giving one variable. Then what are the calculations you need to give? After all the things you need to give after the equal to sign. So I am giving the equal to sign. After the equal to sign, I am going to write the condition for odd. So what's the condition? See, here for even I am giving x equal to 0. The value of x becomes 0 or. But here, what's the symbol means? Not equal to. The value of x is not equal to 0 or not equivalent to 0. This is or operator. Okay, or operator. But here this is and operator. What's the difference between or operator means? Or means any one condition is true means also answer true. But and operator means both the conditions are true means only you will get an answer true. Listen, so here already I have given the value of x is need not to be a 0. And another one condition, even of x minus 1. So I am going to take any one even value. For example, I am taking the even value as 4. So what you will get? 4 minus 1 means what answer you will get? 4 minus 1 means 3. So 3 means which number? Odd or even? Odd or even? Odd. So you need to get the answer written of odd. Understood? So two conditions. The value of x is not equal to 0. That also true. And also even of any number minus 1 means also you will get answer as odd. Understood this program? Okay. So today I have studied about recursive function. What's a recursive function? The function call itself. So why here I am giving recursive means? See, this function will execute till how many, for example, you have given 10 numbers. So till the 10 numbers, like a for loop you have studied in the last year. So till that, till 10 numbers, it will execute and find how many even and odd numbers. Understood? Now you say, so what's a recursive function? Function call itself is called which function? Recursive function. So what's the example program? Program to check whether given number is odd or even. Okay. So what's the program here? They have given two condition, pre-condition and post-condition. So what's the pre-condition? Requires. So inside that I am giving function definition, that is a let r is even of x equal to. So understood? Have you studied? Understood this program? Okay. So next one is syntax for function types. Listen, so function types is nothing but this this one just you have read, no need to mug up. So listen, first to see this first example, x equal to y, that is 1-to-1 function. So here, so x is a function, consider x is a function. So x is giving input to which variable? Y. So x is giving input, which one is getting output? Y is getting output. Okay, so one function x is giving the input to the function y, y is getting output. Next one, see, x1 is giving the input to which one? X2. Listen, x1 is giving input to x2. Now, which one is getting output? X2. Isn't it? See, next one. X2 is giving input to y. So, who is getting output now? Y is getting output and x2 is the input. Understood? Likewise, here x1 is giving input 2 till xn. For example, x1 is giving input to x2. Then x2 is giving input to x3. Likewise till xn. At last, x1 is giving input to y and y will give the output. Understood? So this is the function types. Okay? Okay. So after this, today's enough. So this one, no need to mug up it, just read it. That's all. So today in your notebook, you should write syntax to define function, recursive function. Please, after completion of this session, study these two questions. Very, very important questions. Please don't waste time. Students, remaining, I'll continue in the next class. Thank you, students.